Good morning, dear students. Today we will continue with the balance part of our health, that is indicators of health. So what is an indicator? It is the one which gives an indication of any given situation or a reflection of that situation. And WHO, that is World Health Organization, defines indicator as a variable which will help us in measuring the change. So what are the characteristics of these indicators? It should be valid, that means it should measure what it is supposed to be measured, and should be reliable. Reliable is when you say it is reliable, when many people, if they count it or if they measure it, it should give the same result, or in any different circumstances also it should give the same result. It should be sensitive, that should be, even if there is a minor change in the situation, it should be able to recognize that, and it should be able to sensitive. And it should be specific, and whatever the changes that are reflected in that situation should be shown, that should be the specific, and it should be feasible, and it is relevant. These are the characteristics of indicators. This is the classification of indicators, where you can see mortality, morbidity, disability, nutritional status, healthcare delivery utilization, and social and mental health, environmental indicators, and socioeconomic health policy, social health indicators, and others. It can be written as a different types also, as vital indicators and behavioral indicators. In vital, we consider it as mortality indicators, morbidity, disability, service indicators, and composite indicators, whereas other one is behavioral indicators. Let us see the first one, that is mortality indicators. In mortality indicators, I believe you all know that what is mortality means. The difference between mortality and morbidity. Mortality is death, morbidity is disease. So mortality indicators are crude death rate, that is the number of deaths per 1,000 population per year in a given community. It indicates the rate at which people are dying. Though this crude death rate is not a perfect measure of health status, but it can definitely indicate how there is overall health improvement is happening in that particular community or in that particular nation. Now, expectancy of life, life expectancy at birth, that is the average number of years that will be lived by those people who are born alive into the population, if the current, that particular age specific mortality rate persists. That means if suppose the age specific mortality, that means if you say at the age of 10 years this particular population is expected to live for 80 years in that particular given population. So if the baby is born alive in that particular population at the age of 10 years, that baby is expected to live for 80 years. So that is the life expectancy at birth. It is highly influenced by the infant mortality rate. Now, the life expectancy at birth is used more frequently because it is estimated for each gender separately, like male and female child, because see, the infant mortality rate, we will continue in our next following slides, we will see that. Now, the World Health Organization defines life expectancy as the number of years of a person is expected to live on the basis of current mortality rates and prevalence distribution of health states in a population. Whatever the health conditions that are prevailing in that particular population, and what are the number of average years that person is expected to live on that particular mortality rates. This is called as life expectancy according to the World Health Organization. Now let us see what is this infant mortality rate. It is the ratio of deaths under 1 year of age in a given year to the total number of live births in the same year, usually expressed as a rate per 1,000 live births. That means infant mortality rate is within 1 year period of time, how many people, how many children, or how many child births are happening, and how many people are, how many child are dying in that particular year, within that particular 1 year of period, to the total number of live births that are happening in that particular year. Usually it is expressed as rate per 1,000 live births. You say, like, you know, so many deaths are happened, infant deaths are happened within this 1,000 live births. Let us see, It is universally accepted indicator as the health status of the population. Usually, this is a very common indicator which we usually take it as the health status of any particular country or even the nation. So the infant mortality ratio has come down to 29.9, that is almost 30 in 2018, where it was almost 50 per 1000 live births in 2008. That itself shows that our health condition of the people has improved. So this is one of the best indicators and widely used indicator. Now coming to the morbidity indicators. Now morbidity indicators is the one which describes the health in terms of only mortality rate is misleading, because the people who are dying, mortality rates usually are misleading. So we usually take the morbidity indicators also. These are used to supplement mortality data to describe the health status of the population, where mortality rate does not reveal the burden of ill health in a community, such as mental illness or any particular disease. Whereas in morbidity, it can tell you how many people have got disease with tuberculosis, how many people are having HIV, how many people are having hepatitis or any particular condition, because morbidity is the disease status in the population. So morbidity indicators are also very widely used. Now the following morbidity rates are widely used, that is incidence and prevalence, notification rates, attendance rates at outpatient departments, admissions, readmissions, discharge, duration of stay in the hospital, and the period of sickness, that is the spells of sickness or absence from work or school. These are all the morbidity indicators which to assess the ill health. Disability rates. Now the disability rates are based on the notion that health implies a full range of daily activities. The disability is you are not able to perform your duties or your work. That is commonly used, fall into two categories, that is event type and person type. So if the event is the number of days of restricted activity, number of disability days and work loss days within a specified period, that means you are not able to perform your duties at that particular event. So the number of days that your activity is restricted, or the number of days that disability you have suffered with, and loss of work days. Now if it is a person type, the limitation of mobility, such as bedridden or confined to house, or maybe limitation of activities such as eating and washing. That means you are not able to do your household work also. You are completely bedridden. This is the person type. Now coming to Sullivan's index. This is a commonly asked short notes. This index is computed by subtracting from the life expectancy the probable duration of bed disability and inability to perform major activities according to a cross-sectional data from the population surveys. That is, we subtract from the life expectancy the probable duration of bed disability and inability to perform the major activities. Now HALE, that is health adjusted life expectancy. It is based on life expectancy at birth, but includes an adjustment for time spent in poor health. Now DALY, this is another commonly asked, that is disability adjusted life year. It is a measure of the burden of the disease in a defined population and the effectiveness of interventions. DALY expresses years of life lost to premature death or years lived with disability adjusted for the severity of the disability. See, this DALY is disability adjusted life year. That means if you take it as it expresses the life lost, suppose if the person is expected to live for say 80 years or 90 years, but if he has succumbed to his ill health or whatever the reason may be by the age of 30 years, that means he lost the rest of 60 years or 50 years, whatever you call it. And suppose if he has not been dead also, and if he is completely bedridden, and if he is not able to perform his duties, that itself is a loss of his productivity, right? So the years lived with the disability adjusted for the severity of the disability. One DALY is one lost year of healthy life. This is also one commonly asked question. This is DALY. Coming to the nutritional status indicators. Now, positive indicator this is as. Now, what we usually take for nutritional status, anthropometric measurements, height and weight of the child and low birth weight. These are all the nutritional status, like, you know, by this age, you must have come across, by this age, you're supposed to be at this height and at this weight. From the children, childhood, when we take the doctors, they usually first take the measurement of the child to see their nutritional status. Now, healthcare delivery indicators. Now, how these healthcare delivery indicators are measured? We check the doctor population ratio or dentist population ratio and doctor nurse ratio, population beds ratio. See, when we have this COVID situation right now prevailing, we wanted to assess how many beds are required, how many manpower is required, how much health infrastructure is required, how much do we have? Do we have so much of beds available for the people if they get this severity or if wide range of people are exposed to this coronavirus? So these are all the healthcare delivery indicators. These indicators reflect the equity of distribution of health resources in different parts of the country and how we were providing the healthcare services to the people. Coming to the utilization rate. What is utilization? Utilization is actual utility of the people when they go for the service to take from the doctor. So, their actual coverage is expressed as the proportion of people in need of service who actually receive it in a given period. Usually, we consider it as 1 year. So, within that 1 year, how many people have gone to the doctor to get their treatment for their illness? Now, healthcare utilization is also affected by factors such as availability and accessibility of health services and the attitude of an individual towards his health and healthcare systems. Let us see some examples also here. Bed turnover ratio, bed occupancy rate, percentage of population, average length of stay. These are all the things, because when the person is admitted to the hospital, you will get to know how much discharges are happening, how many people are getting occupied into the hospital, the number of beds and number of occupancy, and the percentage of people who are utilizing family planning programs, how many days they are required to stay back in the hospital for the treatment, or how soon they are getting discharged. All these are all considered as utilization rates. So that is utilization indicator. Now, coming to the indicators for social and mental health. These social and mental health indicates the suicide, homicide, other acts of violence, crime, road traffic accidents, juvenile delinquency, alcohol and drug abuse, smoking, consumption of tranquilizers, drug addicts, then obesity, family violence, battered baby syndrome, battered wife syndrome, etc. See how socially a person is bringing up and how that mental status is happening. So the social and mental health. Usually we see the suicide, homicide, all these acts of violence, in which part of the country this is more, how much people are living, what kind of mental health they're all in. So that we can consider the status, health status of that particular nation also by considering these social and mental health indicators. Another thing is environmental indicator, that is quality of physical and biological environment in which diseases occur and people live. So, for example, the pollution in air, like how we in our country, major cities all are affected to this pollution. The life expectancy has come down drastically in these particular cities because of this pollution. And there is water pollution, radiation, solid waste disposal, exposure to toxic substances in food or drink, all these things. These are all the environmental indicators. Now, socioeconomic indicators. They are not directly measure of health, but they include rate of population increase, per capita GNP. Like, see, socioeconomic status does not immediately tell you that it is not an health indicator, but they are indirectly related to the health. So, how a per capita GNP, gross national product, and then level of unemployment, dependency ratio, literacy rates, especially female literacy rate. Yesterday I have told you the female literacy rate again. So, family size, housing, that means how many people are living in that particular home or within that room. Because in major cities, like if you see in Bombay or Kolkata, where you have densely populated. So, within small houses, there are a large number of people. whereas in rural areas you have big houses and very few number of people living. So these are all the socioeconomic conditions, so socioeconomic indicators. Now coming to the health policy indicators, that is allocation of adequate resources according to the policy commitment, that is proportion of GNP spent on health services, how much the government is allocating the GNP compared to the health conditions, and proportion of GNP spent on health related activities, proportion of total health resources devoted to primary health care. These are all the health policy indicators. So the health policy indicators will tell you how these things are. Now quality of life indicators. Now quality of life indicators is enjoyed by the quality of life enjoyed by individuals and community. So physical quality of life index is one such index. It consolidates three index indicator, that is infant mortality, life expectancy at age and literacy. These are all the quality of life how you are expecting. I think yesterday you have remembered quality of life I have dealt with. So coming to the other indicator, that is social indicators, basic needs indicators, life expectancy, health for all indicators, and millennium development goals. Now if you see social indicators, now what are the social indicators? That is population, family formation, family and households, learning and educational services, earning activities, distribution of income, consumption and accumulation, social security and welfare services, health services and nutrition, housing and its environment, public order and safety, time use, leisure and cultural activities, social stratification and mobility. These are all the social indicators which says how much is the population of the place, how is the family formation happening in that particular nation, and how is the family and households and learning and educational services available to the people, how the earning opportunities, that is employment opportunities in that area, distribution of income, consumption and accumulation, like whether you are able to spend well or not, and we are able to accumulate property or not. These are all also indicators. Then coming to health service, social security and welfare services available to the people, and then health services and nutrition, housing and environment, how is the housing availability in that area. Coming to public order and safety, whether the public is living in proper, considering the social and mental health. I hope you remember that we have dealt in that indicators. So all these are all the social indicators. And basic need indicators includes calorie consumption, access to water, life expectancy, deaths due to disease, illiteracy, doctors. See, these are all the same thing which we are giving in a separate heading here. So these are all considered as basic need indicators. Now coming to health for all indicators, that is health policy indicators, social and economic indicators, indicators for provision of health, and health status indicators. So these are all the other indicators coming under. And there is one more, that is called as Millennium Development Goals indicators, that you can open up in the part textbook and see the same thing which is given in a different headings. Coming with that, we will conclude our session. The indicators of health, this is a very important question asked. It can be asked as a major question also. And the main thing is, health is a fundamental issue of great importance to all health professionals. Is need to identify and tackle the causes of diseases in the society. So the essential principle of health for all is the concept of equity or equality in health. That is, all people should have an opportunity to enjoy good health. With that, we will conclude the session. I hope you have understood. And please refer to part textbook. It is given very well and more detail. If you would like to go once again through that, it will be better. If you have any doubts, please get back to me. Thank you.